Everyone, today we'll be looking at load flow of a power system using Cyan PCF software. So let's open it up. The version I'm using is the Cyan PCF 2.81 revision 2.9. So if you're using PCF, opening PCF for the first time for a project, you need to create a blank database directory. This directory will act as the main folder of your experiment. All the files will be saved in this folder. So click on database and then new blank database directory. You need to specify the folder you'll be working on. I will work on my academic folder in this tutorial folder. Please note the directory of the folder underneath in this box. It is in F tutorial folder. Please note if you want to select this folder, you have to go inside it, click it and go inside it and then press select. You can see Cyan confirms that a new blank database have been created successfully. Click OK. Then we need to go to the file settings in under preferences. You see in under directory selection, we have to specify the path we just created in the database and network item. For the database item, we click on browse. We select the folder that we use to create the database. In my case, it is the F tutorial folder. Please keep in mind you have to go inside the tutorial folder and then press select. See the path has been edited. And for the network folder, we have to do the same. You need to browse and go to the folder, select it. Please note that the folder I have created named tutorial doesn't have any space in it. So a space bar or anything, you can use underscore, but be careful, please do not try to use spacebar, or otherwise PCF will give you error. So when you both enter database and network path as the database directory, you're good to go. Okay, so as you can see in this general error and messages, PCF has created a lot of missing files. Files that were missing in your folder previously. So if you look at the folder, let me open the folder. So this is the original folder where I have created my database. So as you can see, before starting the experiment, there are a lot of files here of weird extensions, but you do not need to worry about that. It will be needed when you conduct the experiment. So we'll study a 7-bus system for our experiment today. It is a 7-bus system with 3 generators, 3 transformers, and a couple of lines. There are 6 loads connected to 7 buses. We'll look into them each one by one. The data for this experiment are given in these tables. The bus, line, fixed type transformer, generator, and load data are given as shown. So let us move on with our experiment. First, we need to close this window and then create on file, click on file, then new study. At first, there are 2 options available for loading network data. We'll use tabular format so that we can input data in a tabular sheet. So we press the use tabular format option and press OK. Then for a new study, you need a network. So as this is a new study, this is a new experiment, we are creating a new network. Press on OK. And for the initial configuration, PCF has multiple example files. So we're starting from scratch, so we choose default 1-bus system. Press OK. Okay, so this is by default a bus window. Bus tab opens, so this is where you enter the bus information. Please note that we have 7 buses in our system, so we can give them ID like B1, B2, B3, B4, B5, B6, and B7. We mainly need these 2 columns. As you can see from the table, the base KV is 11132 and the operating KV is same as the base KV. So we entered them one by one, 11132. 11132, 11132, 11132, and 132. And same goes for the second one. As you can see, you cannot copy and paste it, so you can just do it manually. 11, 132 and 132. So our bus data is complete. Next we move on to the line data. For line data, you can go to L, that is the line, and click on this table format here, show tables. Click on here and the line tab appears. So as you can see, we have four lines from bus 2 to 6 to 4, from 4 to 7. So we name them accordingly. So let me move like here. Yeah. So we give the ID name something meaningful. So suppose we have a line from bus 2 to 6. So we select L26, L47, L24, and L67 as our four lines. The first line is from 2 to 6. So 2 to 6. 47 means 4 to 7. 24 means 2 to 4. Yeah. And 67 means 6 to 7. We then move to the dbase ID. What that means? So in dbase ID, we have to enter all the other parameter values. So you click on that. Okay. A new pop-up appears. At first, we need to add each line has, as you can see, all the lines have the exact same data other than the length. You can specify the length of each line in here, the final column. So in the dbase ID, you have to specify the other parameters. So you click on that. We create a new type, that is, we click on new. We create a database ID of the type of line. Give it any name you want. I'll just name it line data. Okay. Then we have to specify the KV. All the KV levels are 132. The loading limit is 800. We put the loading limit here, 800. And the emergency loading limit can be up to 20 to 30% or 1.5 times the standard loading limit. So in my case, I'll be putting 1200. The R1, X1 values are R1 is 0.4. X1 is 2.4. And B1 is 155.5. B1 is 155.5. Please note, all these values are in ohms per kilometer. So you need to specify ohms per kilometer here. So ohms per length or ohms per kilometer is the same unit in PSAF. So we are done. As all the line has the same parameters, the same parameter values, we can specify the line data for each of them. We don't have to enter them manually. The line data, that database ID that we have created earlier, will do just fine. So selecting for each of them, and we are good to go. So our line data is complete. Next, go to the fixed step transformer. Again, we click on this menu, go to fixed step transformer here, click on show tables, and the fixed step transformer tab appears. So we have a transformer from three transformers from connected between two buses. So we give a meaningful name, T12, connected between one and two buses, T34 and T56. So we specify the from and to buses, T1, 2, T bus 3 and bus 4, and finally bus 5 to bus 6. Okay, then we need to specify the other parameters. As we have three different transformers, we'll create three new database IDs. This will be T12, connected transformer data. The MVA rating is 400. Primary voltage is 11 kV. Secondary is 132. The Z1 value is 0.015. And X1 by R1 is 12.5. We do not have any B1 value specified, so it will be remain 0. The standard loading limit will be 400. And as I specified, I have considered 150% emergency loading limit. So in my case, it will be 600 MVA. And we're done. The same thing goes for T34. We need to create a new database ID, T34. Rating is, in this case, is 500. Primary voltage 11, secondary 132 kV. Z1 will be 0.012. x1 by r1 will be 12, and the standard loading limit will be 500. Yeah, so let's put it 750. Okay, and finally t56, so creating a new database named t56. The rating in this case is 250 MVA rating. Primary is 11, secondary is 132, z1 will be 0.024, x1 by r1 will be 12, and the standard loading limit will be 250, and let us specify this as 375, and we are done with the fixed step transformer. Please save it, press Ctrl S, or otherwise your data may get lost. Click on the same path and give your study file a suitable file name. Avoid spaces. So let us give the name load flow. Give a meaningful name, and then press enter or save it. So keep in mind to save it every once in a while, pressing Ctrl S in your keyboard. So next, go to the generator value. We select the generator tab and press on show tables. We have three generators. Keep in mind we have two different types of generators here, swing generator and voltage control generator. So as we have generator connected in bus 1, 3 and 5, we select G1, G3 and G5 as our bus generator IDs, connected at bus B1, B3 and B5. We then select a database ID. Let's check the generator type. B1 will be swing, and the second and third one will be voltage controlled generator types. In the database ID, we have to create three different database IDs. The first, okay. PCF is asking to put X value. So let's put 0.0001 here, and it will be good to go. Let's for the generation one. Okay. For the generator 1, voltage is at 11 kV and the loading limit rating is at 650 MVA. All right, then we do not need any other information. For generation 3, we create a new database ID G3. Okay, the voltage is at 11 kV, rating is 750 MVA, active generation is 500 from the table here, and max and minimum MVAR requirement will be 400 and minus 300, and that is all we need. Okay, and the final generator will be G5. For that, the voltage is at 11 kV, active generation will be 400, and the MVAR limits will be 140 and minus 100. Okay, and finally we just have the loads left. So we click on, there is no option named load as you can see, instead there is static load. Yes, we click on that, click on show tables, and we then specify the load values. So we have loads connected at bus 2 through 7, so we create that 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. We need the bus IDs, put the bus IDs accordingly, B2, B3, B4, B5, B6 and B7. We put the database IDs here. For each one you have to create separately. L2 requirement is 230. As you can see, the values are not shown here in P load and Q load, so you have to put here as well 230. Okay, and as you can see, the MVA value is calculated automatically. Let's see for the second load, 60 and 8. As you can see, the MVA value is calculated automatically. Inside the database ID, L3, it will be 60 and 8. Okay, L4. Will be 220. Same goes here, L5 is 50 N5. Same goes here. L6 is 130. Same goes here, and the last one is L7. The generation is 250, and same goes here. All right. Okay. So all our data inputs is completed. Now we can move to doing the load flow analysis, which is the prime goal of our experiment. For this, we first click on analysis on the top menu here. We click on select solver, and we select power flow analysis. Oops, sorry. We create power flow analysis and press on select. We then go to analysis again, press on study. We go to the monitoring tab. This is the monitoring tab. We click select here. We click on select, and based on experiment, we have got 23 components which are selected for monitoring. Okay, press on OK and exit. Finally, go to the analysis tab, click on solve. Now you have to select the method of solving the load flow. The standard procedure is to select Newton-Raphson as it is the fastest one. We click on flat start and we apply the constraints. You can specify the maximum number of iterations. In my case, this is the default one is 60. I'll keep it to that. I will keep the iterations to show you, and I will also create the input file for sims tab. I'll show you in just a minute what it means. And then we click on solve. As you can see, some error is being shown here. So let me cancel it and see. It says the line 26 kV base is not correct for 26 and 24. Let me check. So our line 26 and 24, we had 132 kV levels. So let me see. For line 26, okay, I did a mistake. It is 26 from bus 2 to 6 and 2 to 4. So I have to specify bus 2. So let us do that once again. Click on study, monitoring, and select. Okay, and click on solve Newton-Raphson. Click on these options and keep both of these checked, and press on solved. And now it is solved. We have to specify a name for the solution, so I'll give load flow solve and save it. And as you can see, the solution is given here. The Newton-Raphson method took 3 iterations to solve our problem. So let me close it, and this gives our load flow data. But where can we see the load flow results? For that, please note we have this cross icon on top of the electricity sign. This means we have solved the data. We then click on the report option and press on show text report. After clicking it, you can see all the data from the load flow is shown here. This is the summary of our load flow. The total generation of active and reactive power is shown here. Total losses is 2.9 megawatt for active power and 15.1 megawatt for reactive power. There are some abnormalities in our report, like we have some overloaded transformers here. Some overloaded transformers. So if you can increase the loading limit or the emergency loading limit, as you can see, the power flow is 350 MVA. So it is violating the loading limit. So if you increase the loading limit to say 400 MVA, it will not occur anymore. We have some underloaded transformer, that is the power flow is only 120 MVA, but loading limit is 200 MVA. So the underloading is not a big of a deal, but overloading is. So you can mitigate it by changing the loading limit of the transformer, or maybe add a new line between these two buses, so you decrease the power flow between the transformer, through the transformer. You can save this data by clicking here, the box here, right click and export. 2 MS Excel option doesn't work for me, but it may work for you. But if it doesn't work, you can press to Internet Explorer, Let me open my Intel Explorer. Yeah. So as you can see, the data is here and you can copy it. You can press Ctrl A or select all together. You can just press Ctrl A, copy, and you can open your Microsoft Excel and just paste it there. It's just that easy. So you can paste your LoadFlow solution to Microsoft Excel and for storage for future use. And let me show you one thing. The folder, if you sort it by date modified, you can see the .sol file. That is the solution file. For our future experiments, that is if you want to do dynamic simulation using PCF, we'll be needing this SOL file, the LoadFlow file, for further simulation, for further techniques. So this will be needed in our future experiments. So congratulations on completing your first experiment on Cyan PCF software, the LoadFlow study of a power system.